somebody and say, Jesus is going to be celebrated in this place tonight. Y'all put your hands together for Bishop John Bond.
We celebrate you. We celebrate you. We celebrate you.
to this place. You are welcome into this broken vessel. You decide to abide in the praises of your people. So we lift our hands and we lift up our hearts as we offer up this praise unto your name. Listen here. Creation declares your glory, and the universe declares your majesty. Still you choose to abide in the praises of your people. So we offer up this praise unto your name. Say,
welcome
into this place.
Into this place.
Declares your glory, oh, and the universe declares your majesty. Yet you choose to abide in the praises of your people, so we offer up this praise unto your name.
To abide in the praises of
your name. Come on, can we do that right now? Just welcome him. Come on.
Oh, we worship you,
yes, we do, Lord.
We magnify your name. Oh, you're so worthy.
Hallelujah. Come on, welcome him tonight. Come on, come on. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Lord, I want to.
right now. Can you stand to your feet? And just enter in right now. Come on, just open up your mouth and begin to enter into His presence. I'm a living witness of what worship can do for somebody. Come on, that's it. Just open up your mouth and just love Him right now. Hallelujah. We bless your name, God. That's it. Come on, come on. Worship Him tonight. I need some worshipers in here. That's it. Come on. I need some worshipers in here tonight. In spite of everything that I've been through, in spite of every test, of every trial, been stripped, been lied on, been cheated on, been broke, I'm still here. Come on, come on, come on. Enter in. Come on, come on. Somebody give him a praise in here. You know, if it had been for the goodness of Jesus, you wouldn't be standing in here tonight. You know he rescued you and snatched you out of the enemy's hand. I need somebody to give God some glory. I need somebody to praise the Lord tonight. How about two or three people say, I got to praise him. When I see the man he go where he brought me from, I got to give him glory.
Thank you.
Jesus, there's just something about that name. Those of you that know it, you know what I'm talking about. I call him Master, Savior, Jesus. It's like the fragrance after the rain. His name is Jesus. His name is Jesus. Jesus. Let all heaven and earth proclaim that anointing in this place. It just won't let up. I feel the anointing in this place. Come on, some of you know what it's like to lay on that bed and tears run down your face and not know anything else to do but call on the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. I choose to worship.
With thee.
I'm a living witness. He'll heal you. Yes, he will. Come on, I need everybody in here to help me do it right now. Come on. He's healing me.
He's healing me. I'm gonna worship.
Come on, I need you to lift yourself up out of that mess that you're in right now. Come on. Some of you have been down so long. Come on, make up your mind right now. I can't lay here and die. I gotta seek after him. I hear his voice calling me right now.
He's healing me.
I'm coming to you broken tonight. I'm coming to you wounded tonight. I'm coming to you right now. I need your presence in my life. I'm gonna worship. Yes, I am. He's healing me.
He's healing me. I'm gonna worship.
Oh, he's healing me. Yes, he is.
He's healing me. I'm gonna worship.
I'm gonna worship you. Together and praise him. Come on, bless him. He's worthy. He's worthy of glory. He's worthy of honor. He's worthy of honor. He's worthy of glory. Look at two or three people and say, he's a wonder. He's a wonder in my soul. He's everything to me. I don't know what he is to you, but he's been a healer for me. He's been a deliverer for me. Come on, he brought me salvation. Come on, he's a healer. He's a deliverer. Come on, praise him. Come on, praise him. I want you to get across the aisle, touch the two or three people and say, he's a worker in my soul.
That's the reason why
I sing. Praise your name, Jesus. It's an honor to worship you today. We invite your spirit into this house. Your glory. Your presence, oh Lord. Abba, Father, we bless you. Lord Jesus, we give praise to you. Holy Spirit, we welcome you tonight. Somebody lift your hands and make you feel welcome in this house. It's not about us tonight. It's it's all about Him and His wisdom. His grace and His mercy. From the rising of the sun to the going down of the same, Your name is to be praised.
Sweet Spirit, take over this place. Take over this place, sweet Spirit, take over this place. Take over this sweet Spirit.
Somebody, God is great and greatly to be praised. Now take 10 seconds and brag on your God right now. God, you're awesome. God, you're worthy. God, you're holy. God, you're mighty. God, you're full of glory. God, you're a savior. You're a hero. You're a deliverer. Come on, talk to your God tonight, because he's worthy. Lift your hands and say, he's a mighty God. He's a mighty God. Touch two or three people around you and tell him, he's a mighty God. He's a mighty God. He's a mighty God. Yes, he is. Come on, talk to somebody tonight. Y'all know what that is. Did anybody come to bless him? Did you come to praise him? Well, come on. Lift your voice. Come on. Let's go.
Let's go. and then step out on faith and watch God move. You know, I said our time of these prophecies is going short. Our time of folks saying what's going to happen. What about the evidence of the word? Oh, somebody don't want to hear this tonight. But what about the evidence of the word?
But amen, praise the Lord, I'm still standing. Amen. Because he said, when the enemy comes in like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord shall what? Oh, I didn't do nothing but soar over that situation. Because I knew my daddy got it. I said, oh, he got it. But watch this. She was in the hospital a few days. Then I get another call that my spiritual mother of the ministry was in the hospital. So I said, Lord Jesus, I gotta be able to commute because I gotta make this happen. You know, I got my natural mother, and then days later, my spiritual mother. Oh God, we thank you. So, this, y'all don't know how dynamic he is. Sometimes people say they know, but they don't know. Yeah. I'm gonna show y'all how bad he is. Yes, I said, Lord, how I'm going to work this out? I got to figure out how I'm going to commute with both. He said, you don't worry about that because I got this.
All right.
I said, well, you must be about to bring him out. He said, I got this. So I got a phone call. I was on my way up. And my spiritual mother called me. I said, I'm on my way up to my mother right now. Where are you at? What's going on with you? She said, oh, they just put me out of surgery. Everything went well. She said, I'm awaiting. I said, what hospital are you at? She said, I'm at Harbor General. I said, which Harbor General? She said, I'm at the one in Torrance. I said, the one on Carson Street, Torrance? She said, yes. I said, wow, amazingly, that's where my mother is. She said, yeah, they gave me a room. I said, what floor are you on? She said, the fourth floor. I said, what's your room? She said, I'm in 4E3. I almost dropped the phone. I said, my mother is in 4E5. God don't hear me today. You know, that is not a standing ovation to God. Because he made my commute easy. He said, I will not put no more on you.
said, I must be in the wrong room. I said, no, don't be confused. You in the right room. So I just been room hopping. Amen. She said, you know those people that's next door from one another? I said, you better believe it. I told Evangelist Sharon, she said, you know that's the kind of God we serve. I said, that's what I'm talking about. I need somebody that knows this thing with me and question it. But come on, because sometimes folks were doubting it and they were thinking coincidental. But God. But God. Isn't he awesome?
Wonderful. Hallelujah.
Isn't he awesome?
Yes, he is.
Oh, my God. So that is my God-given testimony.
Amen.
So I want you to know that he's always in control.
Amen.
Oh, come on, somebody. He's always in control. He's awesome to us.
Yeah.
I got in there the first night and I said, Mom, what did they say? What's going on when I got in there? She said, well, somebody said it's cancer. I said, and the devil is alive. Now, let me get to the point. Because I ain't got time for this demon today. I said, we ain't going through this. She said, well, that's why. I said, don't let that come out your mouth again.
Amen.
And they ran every test, and all they could say is, something's going on with her gallbladder. I said, well, get it out. We ain't got time. We got to get out of here.
I know that's right.
Y'all taking up time.
Yeah.
You know, we got some meals to cook for her. I got ministry. We ain't got time for this, so let's get this going.
Yes.
And she's out and doing well.
Oh, hallelujah.
Somebody don't hear me today. Oh my God, he's so awesome to us.
Yes.
I glorify him, amen.
Yes.
I thank him, so I'm going to hold this mic up, give reverence to God. Just for all that he is and all that he's doing.
Yes.
He's just doing awesome things right now. And I just feel so grateful in my spirit. And I don't want nobody to miss what he's doing. I'm not selfish.
Amen.
When I see him moving, I pull everyone in.
Amen.
Say, come on, we can't miss this.
Yes,
come on,
yes.
We got to jump on him fast because I don't want y'all to make yourselves miss this.
Amen.
Because he's moving in a mighty way.
Yes.
He's releasing things. He promised me that all my children will have their cars. And he said it would be a chain reaction that I would give each one of your children their cars back to back. They all got their cars back to back.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Oh, my God. Isn't he awesome?
Yes.
Amen.
I said, Lord, get them out the way because I need you to do something spectacular for me.
Amen.
Hurry up.
Yes.
Because he showed me the order in the beginning of the year.
Yes.
Me and my husband talked about it. And we said, Lord, we're willing to sacrifice. Just get them out of our way.
Amen.
Y'all don't know what I'm talking about. The ones that got big children, y'all know what I'm talking about.
Okay.
That's called lifting some burdens so we can be free. Glory to God. Free us in Jesus' name. You know, they know how to rest on you.
Yeah.
I was running after them getting up cars. Y'all give me right now. God is good, amen. So I thank him. And I want it for us, not just for me, for us as a whole. That's why I'm sharing these things.
Amen.
It's just that season where God just outpours on the ministry.
Yeah.
It's a season of outpouring.
Thank you, Jesus.
I give honor to our apostle, our chief apostle, Ricky Barnett.
Amen.
Our overseer, our spiritual father, Lady Barnett, our first lady, our spiritual mother, in their absence. Thanking God for them. Thanking God for what they're doing in this ministry. Thanking God that we are a part of what's happening here also. Amen. So we come here to give back. To sacrifice our time, amen, of love, amen, and giving. Come on here, somebody. You know, it's hard to find people that's willing to give out of love. Because everybody wants something to follow.
Amen.
You know, you do this and I do this for you.
God.
I got out of that fellowship a long time ago.
I know that's right.
Well, if y'all all come to my appreciation and bring $100 and you got 10 pastors sitting on a pulpit, everybody got 100, and you better be you better be at theirs the next time around and get back that same 100 the following month. And then the following month, you better be at this pastor.
time to get that set. I ain't got time for that foolishness.
I know that's right.
If you gonna give me $100, just give it to me. Don't look for me to give it back 2 months later.
Well, I gave you $100 2 months ago. Well, God didn't gave me $1,000 since that $100 that you gave me.
I know that's right.
So, this is not a gambling game.
I know that's right.
I had to get out of that circle. I said, wait a minute, this is a gambling situation.
I know that's right.
I was going in being a blessing, giving, and it was, didn't realize it was a gambling situation. Because they would say, call her, call the prophetess, and bring her team. Oh, the devil is a liar. So God set me free.
Yes, yes.
All right. Amen.
Amen.
Give the Lord a hand, praise and speak. If I bring my husband up here, amen. Thank God for this awesome man of God that he blessed me with. I always tell him, I thank God that he shielded you just for me. I thank God that he didn't allow no one to see you and who you was, because it was just for me.
Amen.
Hello.
Amen.
Hello.
Hello.
For you.
It wasn't for you to see, because it was for you.
Amen.
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 But I thank God for how he's using him. He's so hardworking. Amen. He's at work all day long. Jumps in the car. Maybe we got to get to church because we don't want to preach tonight. I thank God for that, because he don't make excuses of what he needs to do. Amen. He's never too tired. I got to hit the brakes on him sometimes. Nope, you're going to get refreshed for at least 30 minutes. And sometimes you might be walking. I can feel him pounding a little bit. That's all right. Got to get restored, amen.
Yeah.
We are to protect one another, amen. We protect each other, amen. So I thank God for him in taking his stand as a husband, as a father, amen. Thank you for being our pastor of Press Ministry,
amen.
We love him. We love him. Amen. We love him to life, and we thank God for him, and we can't say thank you enough. We can't honor you enough for just positioning yourself in the ministry, amen, and allowing God to use you and being my leader. I thank God for him being my leader. I thank him for teaching me submissiveness, amen. I thank him because I can remember Apostle saying, how is this going to work? Because, you know, my daughter, she always in charge and she's always running the ministry. She's always, but he don't know. I've been waiting for this. You know, but he's so used to me being strong and him pushing me and doing what I do. And I always have to wear two and three hats. Yeah. But when no one knew, I was ready to get rid of that king hat.
I know that's
right. So as soon as he came in, I said, this is your mission. Here's your mission statement, praise the Lord.
Amen.
This is what's required of you. This is what's required of me. Let's line up in the scripture so we know we got it straight. Amen.
Right.
Amen. So I thank him and I praise him for what he is doing. Hallelujah. And for how he's doing it. And I thank him for even him learning submissiveness under this ministry and under his leader. Amen. Because that's what makes a husband submissive, is having a submissive leader.
Amen.
And then being trained, amen, to submit. And a lot of people don't want to submit. But you're going to have to submit to somebody. You're going to have to listen to somebody in order for you to go up. I don't care how deep your thoughts is. I don't care how much word you think you have in your belly. You're going to have to submit and listen to somebody. Somebody's going to have to rebuke you. Somebody's going to make you mad till you get yourself right.
Yes. Hallelujah. Praise God.
You're going to feel like your leader hates you. That's okay. He don't hate you.
That's right.
Just call it discipline.
Yeah.
How you a warrior and you can't take nothing. Warriors take the pain. Warriors take the beauty. Warriors take being sat down. Because they know when they go down, they're coming back up even higher. Oh, I'm talking to the warriors. I'm going to lose somebody in there, brother. I'm going to lose somebody. When your leader says something to you that's good,
amen.
You better believe when he says something of discipline or rebuke also.
Amen.
Because it's good for you.
Yes, yes.
And I thank thank God for his rebuke, his discipline, and all the good stuff, because now we can flow together as one. Amen. We can tear the kingdom down together as a whole. Amen. I no longer feel alone in this fight. Amen. I no longer feel like I'm battling this alone. Amen. I thank God for you, honey.
Yes, yes.
And I praise him for all of who you are and what you do. Yes. And look at him, everybody, and point your hand and say, preach.
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 Preach the word of God.
Preach the word of God.
Amen.
Amen. All right.
Let's give the Lord a hand of praise as we pray. His team, come on. Yes. Oh, hey, hey. Come on. Let's give him a hand of praise. Ain't God good? Ain't he good? Come on. We serve a good God. Despite how he feels, how he looks, he's good. We thank the God. We won't be before you long, but we will be strong. Church tonight, we come to a breakthrough tonight. I need one. Good watch out. The one who keep it up, be it that. It's Sunday. Glory, hallelujah. Let me use you. Let me use you. Good watch. You free me. Keep your shoes on. I'm about to shoot your foot. Glory, hallelujah. It's Sunday. Good
I'm I'm
into the supernatural. Step into with faith. Wish your motion. Get out of my revelation. Oh, push up the case. Get out of my shirt, no question. Get out of my shirt, no question. Well, I'm out of my shirt, no question. of Jesus. Glory to your name. The power of the Holy Ghost. In Yeshua's name. We will celebrate it on the Lord. Let us pray. That's not like God. We take a forward to you. Holy Spirit. Skeptical spirit. We break your power. In the name of Jesus. Glory, hallelujah. Everything that has attached itself to the middle of the Bible, loose your hold in the name of Jesus. I come up against every spell in the name of Jesus. I ask you, Father, to loose the mind, Father, in the name of Jesus. I ask you, Father, to lock the doors, let the whole soul be able to make them unto you in the name of Jesus. As a holy man of God, I take my position and I see the word, God. We judge and we curse on the people in the name of Jesus. Oh, my God, I trust you, God. I take up your kettle. I blow out your kettle. I see you, God, in the name of Jesus.
Thank you. For David, but it was for an example to us how we are to come into God and cry out to God. And because some of us allow the devil to bring condemnation and put a weight on us and make us feel that we're not worthy to come to God because of past mistakes or mistakes, David has made an example. After he killed a man for his wife, he knew how to see God's face. And he killed a man for his wife. But if David would have listened to man, or David would allow what he did to stop him from being the call that was on his life, see, man would have told him, oh, man, you forfeited your call. But no, God didn't say that. He knew how to go before God. He knew how to cry out and confess and repent from his heart to God. And it is for us And it reads like this: have mercy upon me, O God, according to the loving kindness, according to the multitudes of thy tender mercies, blot out my transgression. Wash me thoroughly from my iniquities, and cleanse me from the sin. For I acknowledge my transgression, what I did to that man for his wife. He said, have mercy upon me. Wasn't nobody else. He was talking about him.
Amen. Amen.
According to your loving kindness, according to the multitudes of your tender mercies, blot my transgressions. Wash me thoroughly from my iniquities. Wash me. Clean me. Purify me. For it's me and me alone that have sinned against you. I'm guilty. I take responsibility. I come before you with dirty hands. Wash me with your loving kindness and your mercy. Purify my heart. Take out everything that's not like you. And it comes a time in our life where we got to find ourselves in a place like David, that you truly come before God with a sense of, the thing is, you don't want to wait like he did for the prophet to have to come to him and expose him. You want to be able to examine your own self where you are and go to God and not have to be exposed. Because God will expose. There's no secret sins with God. No, we're not perfect. I understand that. I'm the first one to raise my hand up. But there is a place of being real with God.
Amen.
There is a place of being honest and true with God.
Amen.
And David found out how to get to that place. But it took him to be exposed by the prophet. Openly exposed him. And even in his exposure, he cried and he repented out to God. In words of David, hear the words: to wash me thoroughly from my iniquity and cleanse me from my sin. For I acknowledge my transgressions, and my sin is ever before me. Against thee and thee only have I sinned and done this evil in thy sight, that thou mightest be justified when thou speakest, and be clear when thou judgest. Behold, I was shapen in iniquity, and in sin did my mother consume me, because thou desirest truth in the inward part. He said, because she desires truth in the inward part. What did he say? God know our heart. He knew he could not hide nothing from God. We can hide it from man. We can fool man. But we can't fool God. And one thing I learned from our apostle, he said, don't pimp God. Don't try to pimp God. You might try to play me, but don't you try to pimp God.
That's right.
I didn't learn nothing else out of all my faults. I caught that, baby. He said, don't you pimp God, so you be real with God. You tell God the truth.
Amen.
I didn't learn nothing else from my trials to get to here. I need to be honest with God.
Yes.
I need to keep it real with him. Because he see it all.
Yes,
and his mercy covers truth, not a lie. He came back alive, but he came back truth.
Amen.
Because he know the heart. Man don't know the heart. I've learned wherever you are in your walk with God, he knows your heart. know your time of deliverance and your time of coming out.
Yes.
Man don't know it.
That's right. That's right.
Man might give up. Man might get tired of you. But God knows your heart. He knows. Because he created you. And he formed you in your mother's womb. And he knew you. And he knew everything you'll go through. He knew your process to your purpose. He knew every tear. He knew every fall. Backslide, rebound. He knew that. He counted it. He counted it in the record. He knew your maturity state when it had come. He says, I'll put no more on you than you can bear. So when we find ourselves going through, we got to understand, I serve a God that won't give me nothing I can't handle. Because if I couldn't handle it, he wouldn't let me go through it anyway. He wouldn't allow it. God of his word. He said, I will not. Nothing come on you can't bear. So whatever you're going through, whatever you have, you can bear. It might not feel like it. It might not look like it. But he said, you can bear it.
You
can have it. Because it's only to make you strong. It's only to make you who you are.
Preacher.
In the midst of killing a man for his life. He knew how to cry to God. He knew how to repent. And some of us allow the enemy to beat us up because of our mistakes. We allow the enemy to mess with our minds. Say, God, you have to take this because I can't do it. Some things I've just got to say, God, you have to take this. I'm too deep in it. I get, God, don't take it. You got to get it to me. Free this house. No condemnation to those that are in Christ. You're great.
Thank you, Lord.
You are somebody.
Yes.
You are the righteous of God in Christ Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world.
Hallelujah.
Refuse to be stopped.
Yes.
How can I be stopped when the kingdom is within me? I don't care how many falls it is. You hold on to his unchanging hand. I don't know how many times I've failed. Changing hand. Sometimes you got to look back and remember, if God brought me from all this, why won't he finish carrying me the rest of the way? Sometimes I got to say, God brought me through all that. I know he ain't going to throw me away now. I know God kept me. Some of the things I've seen in the witness, he ain't a God. You got to let me go now. You got to hold on to his one chain in your hand. You got to say, God, I need you to hold me, Lord, in the midst of what I'm going through. It don't look like you're going to make it. When you want to throw in the towel, that's when you got to seek him like you never seeked him. That's when you got to press like you never pressed. When it look like it ain't going to never turn around. When it look like I just ain't growing fast enough. Yeah, you are growing. Yeah, you are holy.
folks think that's not as if they were. You have to look at the mirror sometimes and say, I am a holy man of God. I am a king of the righteous. I might not be ready again, but I'm speaking into your destiny. I'm going to speak that thing into existence. I'm loved. I'm healthy and wise. I am a millionaire. In the name of Jesus, you gotta see yourself in your home, in your car. You gotta see yourself having business for God. You gotta see yourself coming out. You gotta see it in the Holy Ghost. You gotta see it. You're in. He told us one thing. He said, Lord, show me my end. In a jail cell. I said, God, show me my end. Because right now, it don't look too good. Don't look too good right now. Show me my end. Show me to me. Show me your end. Who you are in the end. In your greatness. In the power and the might of Christ. In his glory. In your sanctified state.
Thank you, Lord.
Preaching the word, dancing and singing for the Lord. Letting his glory fall because of his presence and your relationship with him. I'm not going to give a fuck at all. To go a whole other way.
Good.
Somebody need to be encouraged tonight.
Yeah, exactly.
Somebody need to know that you're great in Christ. Uh-huh. I am yourself in Christ. There's three stages to your walk. To save your baby. Respect the baby and make some dumb baby mistakes.
Yes, that's right.
And a teenager.
That's right.
You know a teenager. Teenagers know everything. Can't tell a teenager nothing. Just got saved. You want fire? Understand? Right where you at. But you got to understand. A teenager. I'm a counselor. I want to work at the program. Like men, women sit before me. And they tell me some of those crazy stories, I just look at them. But Lord, let me see them in the spirit. I said, do you believe what you just told me? And you expect me to believe that? I said, you don't know who you are yet. Then he told me, we don't want you to believe that. What you hired me for?
All right. Yeah, that's right.
I want you to do what's in me.
That's right. Yeah.
You can't set nobody in front of me that's bound and don't think I ain't gonna take authority.
Yeah.
In love. And the Lord allow me to get through because it's his glory. It's his glory. He told the owner to do the way he did. It ain't me, it's God. Because we operate and been trained in the supernatural spiritual realm. I'm just seeing it from a spiritual standpoint. You see it from a now. All I need you to do is see it. You see it one way, I listen. I just say, well, are you willing to see it one other way? Are you willing to see it from a spiritual standpoint? If you're just willing to see it. From a spiritual standpoint, not your natural condition. Not where you are naturally. We see where you are naturally. But if you're willing to see it from a spiritual standpoint, that you might just need to be
delivered.
You might just need to be set free. I ain't come to shake the program, but I come to bring the truth.
Amen.
I come to set God's people free in the name of Jesus. To the glory of God.
Amen.
And I'm believing God one day. Well, he's going to set a situation up where he's going to show up and show out in that place.
All right.
And he gonna get the glory. Somebody gonna get set free, delivered right there for all of us.
going to take that program to a whole other place. A Christian program in Christ.
Yeah.
To the reality of the power of God.
Wow.
I just want to encourage you tonight. I'm going to get out your way. Encourage you. Press in. Cry like, read Psalms, get Psalms 51 in your spirit. Create in me a clean heart. And renew a right spirit in me. That was my cry for a long time. Because I was dirty.
Yes. Praise God. Hallelujah.
And blood on my hands.
Yes.
Amen. And witness a lot of things. Create in me a clean heart. And renew a right spirit in me. Then that's your anointing and presence from me.
Yes, my God.
But finish your work in me.
Amen.
Finish your work and take us out. Take us to our destiny. Take us in your glory. And I declare and decree before I close that each and everyone in your homes will be healed and blessed. Each and every prayer for our family members will come to pass in the name of Jesus. Our homes will be blessed. Our homes will be healed. We declare it so. And God, I ask you to release the finances to your people to do kingdom building. Release the finances, God, that they may be able to do the desires that you have put in their heart. I ask you to send the wealth. Send the finances. You give us wisdom to get wealth. Open up doors, Father, that no man can shut. And shut doors that no man can open. In the mighty name of Jesus. Let's give him a hand praise. Hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Come on, man.
We have a brief announcement from our apostle. And the announcement is this week, Friday, March the 14th, 7 p.m., that's going to be the Resurrection Project. A movie prayer petition service. It says, please come out and meet the team and pray with us, believing in the Lord to release the finances for the movie project. That's the resurrection that Apostle's been talking about. It said, number two, this Saturday, March the 15th at 12:30 p.m., he said, Sharp International End Time School of the Prophets is going to be this Saturday. It's number three, all members, if you need a tax donation letter, please see Minister Deanne McCumber or call on the church office phone. Amen. That's it.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Reverend Ross.
Yes, sir. Come over here, God, a hand for you. Come over here, the Holy Spirit.
That gave you the name of God. Amen. Would you bless tonight?
Yes.
Let's give a praise team a hand praise. Because y'all want to start the fire. Yes. Amen. Oh. And then he can celebrate those who was part of the fire. Amen. I love each and every one of you with the love of God. When you start learning how to love people, you will walk in your purpose. You will walk in your destiny. As a man of God, then you can decree and declare some things in your life. But you've got to do it in love. You can't do it to get back. You can't. Amen. I'm going to get him back because he got me. Watch this. In the name of Jesus. Jesus don't play that. Amen. Amen. I'm just telling you real talk. There's certain things that you cannot violate.
Yeah.
Even with your thinking.
Amen.
Don't you know when you start thinking and start thinking, that's evil.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
It's wicked. And
God is still even a person, man. Listen to the man of God. Listen to the person of God that God placed before you so that your life will get better. Every one of you are somebody in Christ. All of you. You wouldn't be here because it's by divine decree. From the youngest to the oldest to the least to the greatest. Because at the foot of the cross, we're all the same. Huh?
Yeah.
Amen. Amen. Do what you do best. If you minister to me, amen.
Amen. Come on.
If you know how to minister in love to a person that's crying out, that's dying in the world, not inside these walls, but outside these walls. See, that's where your work is. When you're in school, when you're going on your job, huh? When you meet them in the store, when you're walking through the park, that's your job. Thank you, preacher. But most of all, thank you, ladies, for allowing us to have your husband for a while. Amen. Y'all are awesome team. Undefeatable. Thank God. Don't let no devil, no demon come between you. Huh? I'm telling you the real, huh? Marriage is about one thing. It's about a lot of forgiveness. 36 years. It's a lot of forgiveness. Huh? It's a lot of letting go and let God. Amen. God wants to run some things out. My wife thought she was sharper than me, and I thought I was sharper than her. Amen. That's the gender. That's what the war saw in. I'm just trying to end with something here. But love never fails. Come on, give God a hand, boys. This is a one-on-one counseling. Amen. Amen. Don't let the sun go down on the wind. I'm telling you.
That's right.
Whatever they done, they ain't done that much. You just didn't get your way. Come on, that's the truth. Amen. Look at all the rocks. Amen. That's what it's about. It's about having fun. It's about having love. See,
amen. Amen.
See, that's why God said back and laugh at the wicked. For real? Are you for real? That's why you laugh and say, for real? You want to exalt yourself? What? Amen. Amen. We thank you, preacher. We thank you. Destiny. Present. Ministry. We praise God for y'all. 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 Amen. And now we'll take up offering. Amen. Come on, give God another hand. Praise. It's an honor. It's going to be good to stand before you.